Listening Library presents Eleanor by Barbara Cooney. Read for you by Suzanne Toren.
From the beginning, the baby was a disappointment to her mother. She was born red and wrinkled, an ugly little thing. And she was not a boy. 3 months later, they dressed her in frills and lace when the Reverend Satterley came to the house on East 38th Street to christen her Anna Eleanor. Uncle Ted was the godfather. Aunt Tissy and Cousin Susie were the godmothers. The beautiful christening dress did not help matters much, but Eleanor's father called her a miracle from heaven. Although she seldom saw him, Eleanor adored her brave and handsome, tiger-hunting, polo-playing father. He called her his little Nell, throwing her high in the air, catching her amid squeals and hugs and kisses. Sometimes, in her solemn way, she danced for him. Eleanor felt he was the only person in the world who really cared for her. When Eleanor was 2½, she sailed for Europe with her family on the SS Britannic. Father was not well. A change of scene, they said, might be what he needed. But the first day out, in a thick fog, the Britannic was rammed by another steamer. Eleanor, screaming, was dropped from the deck high above into the arms of Father in the pitching lifeboat below. From that day forward, she was terrified of the ocean and of heights as well. Eleanor was left behind for the summer with Great Aunt Gracie when Father and Mother sailed again. At home, most of Eleanor's waking hours were spent alone with her nanny, who spoke to Eleanor only in French. When she and Nanny went to the park, the nannies would gather together to gossip. But while other children played happily, Eleanor clung close to Nanny's skirts. Strange children frightened her. Both Father and Mother lived busy lives. Fox hunting, sailing, going to polo matches, the opera, dinners, and balls. Eleanor loved to watch her mother dressing for parties. Softly she would stroke the velvet of her mother's gown. Oh, how very beautiful her mother was. But Eleanor was not. She knew it. And, sadly, her mother knew it, too. One afternoon, put into a clean, starched dress, Eleanor was sent down to the parlor where Mother was entertaining. There, in the doorway, awkwardly biting her nails, she stood anxiously waiting to be asked in. "Don't just stand there, Granny," said Mother to the solemn child. "Come in, please." "I call her Granny," Mother said, turning to her guest, "because she is so funny and old-fashioned looking." Eleanor wanted to sink through the floor in shame. Not everyone lived in luxury, Eleanor soon found out. When she was 6, she went with her father to help serve Thanksgiving dinner at a lodging house for poor newsboys. Some of these ragged.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.